Howdy, I'm back with the Unit 67 from the guys at Drybal in Croatia, and today I'm running it with an SG that's got Tyson Tone PAFs in it, or TTL2s as they're commonly known, into a Achilles Argos amp, which essentially is a JTM45, into a couple of Greenback Heritage speakers in my Laney cabinet. So it's a fairly white bread tone. And I'm doing this because I know a lot of people wanted to hear an old-school style pedal with an old-school style setup. Previously, I'd used the Axe FX, which I just love. But here it is with the real amp. All right, so we switch on the Unit 67. Sustain is off, which means the compressor circuit is mixed out. I've got the EQ out as well by means of this toggle, and the boost switch is at parity, or unity rather, with the lightning bolt position here on the left. Sounds the same, and it should. So if I wind in the compressor, which is based on an 1176, it's hanging on to my notes, but I might want to make up a little bit of make-up gain with the boost knob. So off. And on. Do that with a neck pickup. It's a really fine compressor. It's a great compressor. And we can gun the sustain here for even more compression, or a stronger mix to dry ratio. Again, boost it with the boost knob, which will give you about 22 dB of solid boost if you gun it all the way. All right, so then we get to the EQ section, which is not switched in, but here it is now. Run the boost up a bit because the compressor is on. Or actually, I'll turn the compressor down a bit so we can just muck around with the EQ. You want some more low? You can wind in low. Or out. It'll give you roughly about 8 or 9 dB either side of the midday position. High. Adds a really nice jangle. And then we've got the range knob, and the range knob is basically a Dallas Rangemaster mid-range section. So you got you can hear it kicking in that beautiful honk. So if I really wanted to give the amp a shove, I might drive the boost up, you know, somewhere around here, and have the range knob fairly gunned. So it turns the amp into a breathing animal, a searing, fiery, searing, breathing animal. So essentially what you've got is one part two band EQ, one part 22 dB clean boost, one part Dallas Rangemaster treble booster, and one part 1176 Urey compressor circuit. The compressor circuit also has an input level knob here, plus 10 dB, which is in the up position, which is where we are now, or plus 4 dB, which will let it breathe a little more. We should show you that. Just switch this EQ circuit out. So that's plus 4, here's plus 10. And the plus 10 is hitting the compressor harder in the front end, so you get more compression, which you would need to probably make up with the makeup gain here or the boost level. Now, if your amp is in much more distortion, if it's going into breakup more than my amp is, then naturally that range knob is going to have a much more profound effect. You're going to get sort of Brian May-esque tones with full rich distortion. I'm only in sort of just on breakup mode today, and it's already too loud in here. So that's where I'm leaving it. But there you go. The unit 67 from Drybell. It's a great unit. Sorry for the pun. And if you're into old school effects like treble boosters, 1176 compressors, two band EQ, 22 dB boost, that's the one to get. See ya.